halfway through first period. Dust accumulated on the palm of my raised hand must be a centimeter thick by now. As a chicken leg teacher goes around the room defacing everyone's homework from last night with red pen graffiti that always focuses more on missed commas than the content of the sentences. He finally decides to acknowledge me. Why don't I just drop out? 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 I just drop out. Why don't I just drop out? Why don't I just drop out? Mr. Derek, why do I have a feeling that this is just another one of your dumb comments? You constantly waste my time with your stupidity. Why don't you just drop out or something? Why don't I just drop out? Why don't I just drop out? And it was at that moment that all the statistics began to make sense to me. Statistics of children whose mouth water more for the many tastes of society's corner slang penicillins than for the cardboard textures of diplomas, with pipes more important to fill than class requirements. Statistics of classes cut to avoid battlefields filled with aggravated shrapnel from teachers with exploding tempers, teachers with magnifying glasses at the end of their pointers who feed off the brightness of surrounding students to singe holes in the esteems of those who just need a little more help than others. I want to turn my shot down hand into a fist. I wanted to hit him until he was incapable of speaking anymore. But I didn't want to become another number in an overwhelming manila folder of children arrested in their own school. And we wonder why guns seem to fit perfectly in the hands of this generation's adolescents. Why don't I just drop out? Why don't I just drop out? Why don't I just drop out? Drop out, why don't I just drop out? Why don't I just drop out? Why don't I just drop out? Why don't I just drop out?
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm writing this poem for all the children that filled these rows before me. The ones that made voices in the cracks of schools and in soundproof textbooks. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm writing this poem for all the children who have not yet been named. The ones who will fill these rows I've been struggling in only to be shot down for what they feel. Ladies and gentlemen, the future of America is being crushed between the molars of power-hungry tyrants who think classrooms are boot camps. And if we have any teachers in this audience, I urge you to understand the hand you grab the pen with, hand you grab the chalk with, the voices you speak with are oversized chisels. You must proceed to chisel with caution. But what you say and what you do is written in stone. And if you chisel too hard, these minds can crack.
So what is it, Mr. Derek? What don't you understand now?
I just want to know if I could go to the bathroom.